Following the sinking of the Titanic, SOLAS, one of the most important ship safety treaties today, was adopted in London. Then, in 1948, after the founding of the United Nations, the International Maritime Organization was born to deal with shipping matters. Shipping was changing rapidly, and the first container ships were soon trading. 10 years later, the 21st country ratified the IMO Convention, triggering its entry into force on 17th March 1958. Many new treaties and codes followed, making shipping safer, simpler, and standardized. Then, in 1967, the oil tanker Torrey Canyon grounded off the coast of the United Kingdom, causing the world's first major oil spill. This led to IMO action to improve tanker safety, response when spills do occur, and compensation for victims. The result of this coordinated effort is that 99.99% of oil carried by ships arrives safely at its destination. Throughout the 1970s, the IMO adopted a series of important international treaties on safety and environmental protection. There was the Revised Convention on the International Regulations for Preventing Collisions at Sea, and Conventions on Safe Containers, the Prevention of Pollution from Ships, on Maritime Satellites, and on Maritime Search and Rescue, ensuring people in distress at sea can be rescued promptly, no matter where the accident happens. By the 1980s, the IMO had more than 100 member states, so the new IMO headquarters was built in London. And IMO established the World Maritime University in Sweden and the International Maritime Law Institute in Malta. IMO was undertaking more missions in the field to train people and help countries apply the IMO rules. New ocean protection measures came into play in 1990. Australia's Great Barrier Reef was designated the first of many particularly sensitive sea areas. Other special areas set strict rules for the discharge of oily waste. More environmental action followed, with a ban on dumping plastics from ships into the sea, regulations on air pollution, and a treaty on ballast water designed to stop the transfer of invasive aquatic species. The fight against climate change led to mandatory requirements aimed at reducing CO2 and GHG emissions. By 2000, cruise ships were carrying over 3,000 people, and new regulations were developed to ensure their safety. IMO also adopted a code for ships navigating in polar regions. New technologies, such as electronic charts, black boxes, and automatic identification systems, were made mandatory. With the rise of modern piracy in the 90s and 2000s, IMO supported countries and ships to deal with maritime security. All seafarers today are highly trained to IMO's international standards. In 2018, we celebrate 70 years since the adoption of the IMO Convention. IMO today has more than 170 members, and as we look to the future, we see great opportunities in our support of the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, as well as the challenges of automation, cybersecurity, and climate change.